Good morning, all of you. Today I'll be starting off with a new chapter, that is inverters. Now, this is the notes on inverters. You can take down the notes while I go through. Now, what is an inverter? Inverter, আমাদের সবার বাড়িতে আছে আমরা জানি যখন আমাদের পাওয়ার অফ হয়ে যায় we get our supply through the inverter. Now inverter এ কি হয় DC supply থেকে AC supply conversion হয় inverter এর মাধ্যমে. Means we have a fixed DC at the input side and from the fixed DC we get a variable AC at the output of the inverter. Now variable AC means the variable AC can be have a variable magnitude or a variable frequency. Now variable frequency আমাদের ইন্ডিয়ায় আমাদের frequency কত 50 hertz মানে time period 20 millisecond. তো variable frequency আমরা কি করে পাবো by varying switching frequency on the power semiconductor device আমরা variable frequency that means we can vary the time period as well. If the variable voltage পাওয়ার জন্য আমাদের দু রকমের কন্ট্রোল হতে পারে, একটা হতে পারে এক্সটার্নাল কন্ট্রোল আর একটা হতে পারে ইন্টারনাল কন্ট্রোল টু ভেরি দ্য ম্যাগনিটিউড. এবার এক্সটার্নাল কন্ট্রোল এখানে দু রকম ভাবে দেখানো আছে. দেখো এখানে ইনপুট সাইড এসি আছে, ইনপুট সাইড এসি থেকে we have a control rectifier here. I'm pointing out, see. This is my AC input. From the AC input, we have a control rectifier. Control rectifier diye amra ekhane ekta variable DC pelam. Variable DC, we feed it into a inverter and we get a variable AC at the output, variable voltage. এছাড়া আরেকটা বেটে আছে, we have a fixed DC at the input. সেখান থেকে DC to DC converter, that is what we know as a chopper. সেই chopper দিয়ে we get variable DC at the output. সেই variable DC at the output is again fed to an inverter. সেই inverter থেকে we get a variable AC voltage. Now, এই AC যেটা আমরা পেলাম, we cannot connect this circuit for real-time applications because at the output we get AC voltage which is of a square waveform shape but not sinusoidal waveform. So this is a challenge for design engineers because the sinusoidal waveform is not obtained and the square waveform has got lots of harmonics. So here we get this waveform, we get this square waveform as output from an inverter, but the desired is this sinusoidal waveform. So here we are getting the waveform as a square waveform. Their fundamental component is this, the fundamental component is the sinusoidal waveform. A square waveform, if expressed as a Fourier series, we get the odd harmonics here, n is equal to 1, 3, 5. Our expression is 2 EBC by n pi sine n omega naught t, where omega naught is the fundamental frequency. তাহলে এটা আমরা লিখতে পারি as V0t is equal to 2 EBC by pi, this is for the fundamental frequency, n is equal to 1 put করে sine omega naught t plus 2 EBC by 3 pi, n is equal to 3 put করে sin 3 omega naught t plus 2 ADC by 5 pi sin 5 omega naught t plus so on and so forth. তাহলে আমাদের এই যে waveformটা, এই যে square waveformটা, that is resolved into this fundamental frequency, যেটা এই componentটা হচ্ছে, plus এটা হচ্ছে third harmonic, এটা হচ্ছে, আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি দেখো, third harmonic মানে within the time period there are three waveforms sinusoidal. This is the fifth harmonic plus 7 plus 9. So what we desire to remove this harmonic components and this is the only desired component. But a removal of harmonic components, removal of harmonic components, either we can use filter circuit or PWM technique for pulse width modulation technique. That is, we have it here. To remove harmonic components, either we use a filter circuit or we have the PWM technique. V0t can be written as V01t plus V03t plus V05t plus V07t, that is all the odd harmonics, so on and so forth. V01t is equal to 2 EDC by N pi, N is equal to 1, sine N omega naught t is equal to 1. The letter of the first fundamental frequency, first fundamental component. In RMS value term, this is a peak value. The RMS will be Vm by root 2, 2 EDC by root 2 pi. You can take a letter root 2 EDC by pi. Total RMS value of this waveform, that is our square waveform, it is total RMS value by 4 kilogram of keyboard therapy. Total RMS value by 4 kilogram waveform. This is an alternating quantity. It is RMS value by 4 kilogram of square for a filly. It was square for EDC by 2, ashi EDC square by 4. The root of the mean of the squares, the EDC square by 4 divided by T into T. এখানে দেখো EDC স্কয়ার বাই 2 বাই t করলে আমাদের মিনটা আসবে আর ইনটু t করলে আমাদের এরিয়াটা আসবে তাহলে t t ক্যান্সেল আউট করে কে উই হ্যাভ EDC বাই 2 অ্যাজ দি RMS ভ্যালু Now, distortion factor, we know. Distortion factor, we know, is the RMS value of the first fundamental component by the total RMS value. She can take camera ashi pi to root 2 by pi, which is independent of the peak value of the output voltage. Now, V01 peak is equal to 2 EDC by pi, V01P, V01P, 2 EDC by pi. Now this 2 EDC by pi is greater than EDC by 2. EDC by 2, man, eta peak is a value. So we can write V01 peak is greater than V0 peak. Total harmonic distortion, this will be equal to 1 by distortion factor square minus 1. This is 48.43%. This is a huge distortion. So this is not desired and this is a challenge for engineers to work with. At high distortion, we can't do anything. So IEEE 519-1992, total harmonic distortion, allowed total harmonic distortion, they are at less than 5%. So V0T will be equal to V01T plus V03T plus V05T. So each component, these has to be removed. So V0 RMS will be equal to V01 RMS plus V03 RMS plus V05 RMS, on and so forth to infinity. So V0 RMS, total RMS will be equal to root of the squares of this value. So we can write V0 RMS square will be equal to V01 RMS square plus V0 harmonic components, the RMS value of the harmonic component square. So V0H harmonic component square will be equal to V0 total RMS square minus V0 the fundamental component square. From this, we get the total harmonic distortion as 0.4843. This is independent of the peak value, it is 48.43%, which is very high. Now, this is single phase clock bridge voltage source inverter. Now, this is single force, single phase half bridge voltage source inverter. We have two DC sources, EDC by 2, EDC by 2. Here we have the load. Here we have two switches, and here we have two diodes, which are called the feedback diodes. Now, see. S1 and S2, these are the two switches which can be BJT, MOSFET, GTO, IJT, MCT, etc. depending upon the current and voltage requirements. Here, from the time period 0 to T by 2, S1 is switched on and S2 is at off condition. So when S1 is switched on, the current flow in the path will be this. एक बार दी जब करंट फ्लो करे, व्हाट विल बी द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द लूप? दैट्स प्लस माइनस V जो এখানে যে দেখানো আছে, দিস উইল বি প্লাস EDC / 2. তারপরে T / 2 থেকে T অবধি সুইচ S1 ইজ ওপেন এন্ড সুইচ S2 ইজ ক্লোজড. সাপোজ উই হ্যাভ আ রেজিস্টিভ লোড আউট হিয়ার. সো হিয়ার নাও গিভেন T / 2 টু T, দিস কারেন্ট ফ্লো উইল বি দেন থ্রু দিস পাথ. তাহলে আমাদের যে আউটপুট পোলারিটি অফ ভোল্টেজ সেটা রিভার্স হয়ে যাচ্ছে, এইটা তখন প্লাস এইটা তখন মাইনাস. সো হিয়ার দ্য ওয়েভফর্ম হুইচ উই আর অবটেইনিং, দ্য ওয়েভফর্ম হুইচ উই আর অবটেইনিং The waveform which we are obtaining is this. So the output voltage is plus EDC by 2 and this is minus EDC by 2. So we get an alternating waveform, an AC, out of a DC source. Here the diodes are not coming to any use because we have considered a resistive load out here. If this load would be inductive, then this diode would act as feedback diodes and would have come to use, which we will consider later, which will be seen later. Now IS1 is the current through the switches. IS1 is the current through the switches. IS1 is the current through switch 1. It current is equal to EDC by 2R. When during the time period of 0 to T by 2, from T by 2 to T, the current is 0. Again, from T to 3T by 2, there we have current, and again 0. IS2 is the current flowing in switch S2, where the current flows during the time period T by 2 to T. And finally, the current at the output flows is of the same nature as the output voltage and having the magnitude EDC by 2R. Here we can say period 1, T greater than 0, less than equal to T by 2, switch 1 conducts and V0 is equal to plus EDC by 2, and period 2, T is greater than equal to T by 2, less than equal to T, S2 conducts and V0 equal to minus EDC by 2. Now here we have certain expressions for RMS value, output voltage, switch current, etc. Single phase half bridge voltage source inverter with our load, which we discussed few minutes earlier. Now, output RMS value VDC by 2, which we have seen previously. This one. Output RMS value is equal to VDC, EDC by 2 or VDC by 2. Now this is Fourier series expansion. V0T is equal to Y is equal to 1, 3, 5 to infinity to VDC by N pi sine N omega naught T. I0T is equal to N is equal to 1, 3, 5 to infinity to VDC by N pi R sine N omega naught T. The fundamental component will be equal to, with the expression with N is equal to 1, we get V01T and I01T. This is I01 max and this is V01 max. Now, average switch or source current and RMS switch is source current. Now, IAS average will be, this is the waveform for switch current. This IS average will be equal to the output current into the instant during which the current is flowing, that is T by 2 divided by the total time period, that is T. This is coming as I0 by 2. And the RMS value will be equal to root over I0 squared into T by 2 by T. So this comes as I0 by root 2. Now, fundamental average value of switch current and fundamental RMS value of switch current. Now, the fundamental current is a sinusoidal waveform. So, here the sinusoidal waveform has a maximum value of I0, 1 max. Now, IS0, 1 average, if we see this expression, IS0 on average is equal to 1 by t, 0 to t by 2, I0 1 max sine omega naught t d omega t. We'll get this expression. And similarly, for IS0 1 RMS, we will get this expression. Now, power across load due to fundamental will be V0 1 RMS, I0 1 RMS into cos phi 1, where cos phi 1 is the fundamental displacement factor. It is the cos of the angle between the fundamental value of voltage and the fundamental value of current. Fundamental power delivered by each source will be VDC by 2. This is the voltage of each source into the current IS01 average. And this comes as VDC squared by pi squared 1 into 2 due to both sources. Total power across load is V0 RMS, I0 RMS cos phi. Phi is equal to 0 because there is no lag. This is a resistive load. There is no lag between the voltage and the current. This is V0 RMS into I0 RMS, or V0 square by R is I0 square RMS into R. Total power delivered by each source will be equal to VDC by 2 voltage of each source into IS average, and this comes as VDC by 2 into I0 by 2. Now, this is single phase half bridge inverter with RL load. Here we have the same circuit, but the load is an RL load. This is my VDC by 2. This is my S1. This is D1. Similarly, this is S2 and this is D2. Now here, you can see that this is the waveform for the voltage. There is no change in waveform for the voltage. The output voltage will remain the same. This is plus V0 and this is minus V0. Okay, so here when the switch S1 is on, this is an RL load we've considered. So the flow of current will be this. Flow of current will be VDC by 2, S1, RL load, and you are back. Now, here, before this instant, before omega t is equal to 0, switch S2 was active. Now, switch S2 was active means the flow of current was through this part. That is minus VDC by 2, load S2, and in this direction. Now, due to the presence of the inductive load, here the current change will not be instantaneous when this switch is open. That means the current will try to flow in the same direction. Now, for the current to flow in the same direction, what will happen? This diode D1 will act as a feedback diode, and this diode T1 will send current back into the upward source. That is, in this instant, from this instant to this instant, here, as you can see, this for the phi angle, this instant D1 will turn on, and here D1 will turn on, it will act as a feedback diode, and from this instant to this instant, S1 will turn on. S1 will operate and current will flow in this direction. Again, from this direction, from T/2 to here, this is not 90 degree, or this is not T/4, because this is not a purely inductive load, this is an RL load, and hence this angle is a bit less than 90 degree. So from this instant to this instant, D1 will conduct. From this instant to this instant, S1 will conduct. Again, from this instant to this instant, D2 will conduct. And this instant to this instant, S2 will conduct.
এটাকে ক্রস করো, পয়েন্টিং এর জন্য এটা ক্রস করবে, না ক্রস করলে তো নিয়ে যাবে, এটা মাউস হিসেবে আছে কি ক্রসই করতে হবে? আবার করে ভালোভাবে শিখে করতে পারো, বুঝলে?
So you can see that these are the switches, S1, S2, T1, D2 are the diodes. So from this instant to this instant, So here, we can see the switches S1, D1, S2, D2. Now, I just said that this is an RL load, not a purely inductive load. If it would have been a purely inductive load, then this at T by 4, this change of exponential rise of the current would have taken place, and the current would have lagged the voltage by an angle purely equal to 90 degrees. So here, first, before I said T is equal to 0, S2 switch was on. So S2 switch was on means the flow of current was in this path. So when S2 switch will be off, the current inductance in this path, inductance through the load will not allow the change of current instantaneously, and the current will try to flow in the same direction. So in order to maintain the continuity of current, this diode D1 will conduct, and it will act as feedback diode and will feed back energy back to this upper source. So D1 continues to flow in this interval as long as the inductor has left energy in it, which is transferred back to the upper source. And similarly, after that, S1 conducts. When switch S1 is driven, it conducts. And after that, again, D2 conducts due to the presence of L in the load, and then S2 conducts, and this is the configuration of a single phase half bridge inverter with an inductive load, with an RL load. Here, whatever I have said, I have written it down. You just go through the notes slowly. I0T, this curve is exponential. Output AC voltage, I0T lags voltage by 5. S1, switch S1, V0 greater than 0, I0 greater than 0. D1, V0 greater than 0, I0 less than 0. Here, it's a single phase full bridge inverter with L load. We were discussing half bridge inverter. This is full bridge inverter. We have taken a purely inductive load here. Here again, there are feedback diodes D1, D2, D3, D4. There are four switches S1, S2, S3, and S4, and a single voltage source VDC. You can see from the waveform. See from the waveform that output voltage is a square waveform, but the current, output current, is close to a triangular waveform. Actually, it's exponentially increasing and exponentially decreasing, but it's nearly a triangular waveform. And we can see that the diodes which are conducting, here D1, D2, here switch S1, S2, then D3, D4, and then S3, S4. These are the expressions of RMS value, conduction of each diode, conduction interval, diode, conduction interval of diode, expression for IT average and IT RMS. So we have covered single phase half bridge inverter with resistive load, single phase half bridge inverter with inductive load, and single phase full bridge inverter with inductive load. If you have any doubts in the lesson today, please come up with your doubts. You can post your doubts in the classroom, Google Classroom, where I'll be uploading this video. And feel free to come up with any problem which you have. Hope this session is helpful for you all. Thank you.